Welcome! In this video we are building our first contract, which will store and retrieve a value from the Aeternity blockchain. We will learn about data types, functions and the state of our contract. Let's get started and finally program our first smart contract on Aeternity. The contract for our MemeVote dApp. So let's delete this. A smart contract, or simply a contract, consists of data and functions, which are stored on a specific address on the Aeternity blockchain. To create a contract, we use the keyword contract, followed by a name. I will call it MemeVote. Important to note here, the name needs to start with a capital letter. Okay, now in the first version of our contract, we simply want to save the URL of the meme to the blockchain, and then read it out from the blockchain. Everything will happen on the testnet, of course, so we don't have to spend real money while testing it. But before we start, there's one important concept we have to learn. That is the state of our contract. Basically, you can imagine the state as the data of all the values that we can change through the execution of our contract and that we want to save to the blockchain. Now that we know what the state is, let's think about what kind of data type we want to store first. For now, we just want to store an URL. Let's head to the Aeternity resources to look at some available data types. At the recording of this video, the best documentation available is on GitHub, but I will update it and put the link in the description of the video. These are the data types we can use in Aeternity, here simply referred to as types. We have the uint, an unsigned integer, which is a whole number which is just positive or zero. This makes it a bit cheaper to use than a normal integer. At the recording of this video, the uint is not fully implemented, so we can't use it yet. Int is an integer that can be negative, positive or zero. The address holds a number as a hex. We use this type for our wallet address to send and receive AE token. A little note here, I will refer to AE tokens subsequently as eons. We have booleans that can be truth or false, strings, they are a sequence of characters, and lists. Lists are similar to ordered arrays. The elements inside a list must have the same type. Tuples are similar to lists, but the elements can have different types. And we have records. They behave similar to objects, but without functionality, or also similar to structs in Solidity. We can store fixed key names and typed values. The last thing we are going to get into here are maps. They are similar to associative arrays, dictionaries in Python or hash maps in Java. We can dynamically map keys to a value, or rather their types to each other. We use records and maps later and get more into them, so don't worry if this explanation was a little abstract. So what data types are we going to use here? For now we have a string, the URL, that we want to save and access. So let's use record. We have a fixed key with a value we can access. So we use a keyword record, and like we said in the beginning, this will be the state, the values we want to save to the blockchain. So we also need the keyword state. And now in curly brackets, we name our key URL and specify our data type, which in this case will be a string, so we can save the characters of the URL of our meme. The next thing we need in our contract is an init function, because the state must be initialized when the contract is instantiated. So when we deploy the contract for the first time, the init function is executed and its result is stored in the blockchain. In the init function, we assign the key URL to our value, which is the web address of our meme. In this case, I will use a URL of a crypto meme I like. Okay, this is pretty cool. We can save an URL to the blockchain. But now in order to verify this is actually true, we also need a getter function that can access this value. So let's make a new function and call it getMeme. It will have no arguments, and we also specify that it will return a string. This helps us to make the code more readable and also more safe, because the compiler warns us if the returned value is not a string, but this is optional. Now we can access the state of our contracts from inside it, through the variable state. We want to access the value of the key URL, so we can write state.url. Now we need to specify the accessibility. Contracts have a public API, and some functions can be accessed from outside. In a previous version of Sophia, we would have used the keyword public in front of a function to declare it public. But in the newest version, instead of public function, we use the keyword entry point. This was changed for safety reasons, to avoid exposing functions by accident. Functions with the keyword internal can just be called internally or by inheriting contracts. And functions annotated private can only be called from inside the contract. In our case, we want to be able to call our getMeme function from the outside. So let's use entry point. And we also will make the init function publicly available. Perfect! That's our first contract. Now let's test this. First we have to compile it. And we got no errors. This looks already very good. Our init function doesn't have any parameters, so we don't need to enter anything in the arguments. Let's deploy it now to the Aeternity blockchain of the testnet, of course. And now we can call it. Because we don't change the state of our contract, we can use a static call here, which is fast and doesn't cost gas. And we need to call our getMeme function. So I will enter its name in here, getMeme. We don't have any parameters, so no arguments. We have to define the data type that we will get back. So in our case, it's a string. And this looks nice. Let's check it. And that's a meme. Perfect. Our first contract works successfully on the Aeternity blockchain. Of the testnet, of course. Okay, let's build one more function in this video. At the moment, our function is very passive. It can just read out data. So the next thing we want to do is to save our own string containing an URL to the blockchain. This function needs to be public again, because we want to access it from the outside. And now comes a new keyword we have to use. It's a stateful keyword. Every time that we are going to modify the state with a function, we have to use it. At the moment it's optional to use the keyword stateful, but it will be mandatory in the future, so let's already use it. And we need to use entry point again, because we want to call it from the outside. Now let's give it a name. RegisterMe. This time we also have a parameter. Let's call it input. We also specify the type that needs to be entered. This will be a string. If we want to update the state of our contract, we use a put function. Let's update the value of our URL key from the state with the new input value of the function. Nice, now let's test this. We compile the code, this looks good, and let's deploy it. Okay, now let's use our new RegisterMeme function. We need an argument. Let's use a sample URL, url.com. The return type will be an integer. Now let's call our getMeme function again. Nice, this looks very good. With this contact, we are already able to store and retrieve data from the Aeternity blockchain. But at the moment, we are just able to store one key value pair. So we collectively can just store one meme. So we don't have further information on it. In the next video, we are going to change that.